الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. ثم أما بعد، is it permissible for you guys when you sit at home doing nothing that you just يعني nothing to do and you're not in the mood of reading Quran, you're not in the mood of making salah or ibadah, you're not in the mood of doing dhikr. So what type of dhikr would you think of if you're in that mood? What would you do? Ibadah, something ibadah. Tell me what ibadah, what would you think of doing? Still far, listen to the Quran. How about just go out, have a walk, and just try to see if you can meet some Muslims and give in salam? Would you think of that? I mean, here in America, perhaps it's hard to go have a walk and find that many Muslims to give salam to them. But subhanAllah, some of the Sahaba, they used to do that. And here is hadith, al-Tufayl ibn al-Tufayl ibn Ubayy ibn Ka'b, أنه كان يأتي عبد الله بن عمر فيغدو معه إلى السوق. Al-Tufayl, the son of Ubayy ibn Ka'b, he used to go to Abdullah ibn Umar. So they walk, he walks him to the marketplace, إلى السوق, like going to the mall, for example. قال فإذا غدونا إلى السوق لم يمر عبد الله على سقاط ولا صاحب بيعة لم يمر على سقاط ولا صاحب بيعة ولا مسكين ولا أحد إلا سلم عليه. He said when Abdullah ibn Umar used to go to the marketplace, he would pass by all these people. He would pass by stall owners, by customers, by peddlers, anyone who's in the marketplace, anybody. And when he passed by those people, he would say salam to them. That's what just, he goes to the souk, not to buy, instead just to go to spread salam. That's all. So one day he says, قَالَ فَقُلْتُ لَهُ مَا تَصْنُعُ بِالسُّوقِ وَأَنْتَ لَا تَقِفُ عَلَى الْبَيْءِ وَلَا تَسْأَلُ عَنِ السِّلَعِ وَلَا تَسُومُ بِهَا وَلَا تَجِدْ فِي مَجَالَةِ السُّوقِ. He said, what do you want to do about, you know, going to the marketplace if you are not going to sit there to check the market, to see that the merchandise is, perhaps you make a deal, or even buy something, what are you going to be doing in the marketplace if this is what you do? Basically, it's not your place then to go there. فقال عبد الله بن عمر قال وأقول اجلس بنا ها هنا نتحدث. He said to him, let's sit down here and just have a talk. So just go keep walking and just giving salam here and there doing nothing. Why don't we just sit down here so we can talk? فقال رضي الله تعالى عنه عبد الله بن عمر, he told him, قال يا أبا بطن وكان الطفيل أبو بطن يعني عنده بطن كبيرة. He told him, basically, he said to him, oh, Abu Batn, which means يعني, Abu Belly, basically. He had a big belly. So he was saying, talking to him, Ya Abu Batn. He said, إِنَّمَا نَغْدُو مِنْ أَجْلِ السَّلَامِ. He says, the only reason we go to the marketplace is just to spread as-salam. That's all our business in this marketplace. Just to go and spread salam. I know that perhaps most people, it doesn't even cross their mind to go to the marketplace just to give salam to the people. That perhaps would be the last thing to do. قَالَ فَنُسَلِّمُ عَلَى مَنْ لَقِنَا. We, in this case, we go to the marketplace so we could greet everyone that we meet. And I have seen this practice from some of the mashayikh and the ulama. One of them was Wallah Shaykh Al-Utaymeen, rahimahullah ta'ala. I remember we used to walk with Shaykh Al-Utaymeen from the masjid to his house. It's quite a good walk, yani, a walk of maybe 15 minutes walk. And through this long walk, he would be, same thing, passing by anybody. And he would send salam, salam alaikum, salam alaikum, salam alaikum. And during that even he would be giving fatwas, answering questions, and even explaining some of the books that had been read to him when he was walking. Because the students, as they walk with him, he gives every 2-3 minutes to one of these students, they will read from a book, he explains it, they ask questions, he answers them, and he talks to people and so forth. So eventually, if they have something private, he sends everybody to the back, walking with them. But still, when he meets someone on the way, he would send salam, to say salam to them. I remember even one time, we passed by a bakery, and the baker was at the door. So the sheikh said, salam alaikum. It seems that the guy did not hear the sheikh when he said the salam. So he didn't reply the salam. So the sheikh, again, he said, salam alaikum, louder. The man did not hear. The sheikh, he stopped. He goes, salam alaikum. So eventually the man, he said, alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And then the sheikh kept going. Eventually, just go so that you spread the salam. What is that meaning exactly? That's exactly the hadith that we discussed yesterday or the day before that. when Allah subhanahu when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he said, "Afala adullukum?" Shall I guide you to something that if you do, you become, you spread peace? And he said, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "Qala four things. If you observe them, you'll enter al Jannah in peace." And one of them he said, "Wa afsha al salam," that you spread salam and the greetings among the people. Wallahu ta'ala. Any question, O Jama'ah? Yes.
I've seen that in the office example, when you start in the morning, you say Assalamu alaikum, fine. Like mm-hmm. After like 30 minutes, 1 hour, the same guy passed by and again says Assalamu alaikum, another hour, Assalamu alaikum. I think that's too much, isn't it?
Let's say the question.
Once in a day is enough if you're in the same office.
The question, if you work with some Muslims in the same office, so in the morning when you come in, you say Assalamu alaikum. But after maybe half an hour, 45 minutes or an hour, you had to go out. And then you come back.
Assalamu alaikum.
Yeah, whatever. You just go back and you come back again to the office. You do you have to say salam again? Ya Jama'ah?
Yes.
Here's the thing. In terms of obligation, what is obligatory is to respond to the salam if you are greeted. To initiate the salam is mustahab, recommended. Meaning, if the person wants to spread the salam again, Bismillah, go for it. As a matter of fact, I do that. My mom, she kept actually even complaining, even at home. I go from one room to the other and say salam. So my mom sometimes she goes, what is this? Salam alaikum, salam alaikum. Once is enough. But khalas, subhanAllah, it becomes natural and it becomes, you don't have to think about it, spontaneous completely. You come in, you say salam, that's it. It's good, inshallah ta'ala. And there is nothing wrong, inshallah, spreading salam. So take it easy with the people.
The four things were ifsha salam wa at'an al-ta'am wa salatu wa nasu niyam.
Wa salatu al-ta'am. Nah. Khair inshallah. Subhanakallah wa hamdika. Shukran ala ala. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.